Labeled.
Wishing you a nice morning. This is BN Jha welcomes you in the e-learning program of Modern English School. Students, we are facing great pandemic situation of COVID-19. But we have to do our job, we have to do our work without time is passing day by day. Today, we are going to revise our first lesson of chemistry for class 9th, which is matter in our surrounding. Good morning, students. So, this is the first lesson of chemistry. And we must know what is chemistry. Actually, students used to say that chemistry is very difficult subject. But to my knowledge is concerned, chemistry is very interesting subject and much easier than other. This subject is correlated with our life. If we wish to understand this beautiful world, we must know chemistry. And therefore, chemistry is a branch of science which deals with constitution, property, and applications of matter in the well-being of mankind. Here, chemistry is related to mankind. So, the students, the first lesson we have described properly, and today we need to revise it. So, the first word is matter. Matter is anything which occupies a space, has mass and resistance, is known as matter. To understand this lesson, we must know the characteristics of matter. Matter is characterized by the following ways. First of all, matter is particulate in nature. That means matter is made up of particles. Secondly, the particles of matter is in continuous motion. And thirdly, particles of matter attracts each other. So, if we understand these characters, we can understand the states of matter, solid, liquid, or gas. Good morning, students. Dinesh Kumar, Arun Kumar, good morning. Kabir Singh, good morning. Ladan Kumar, good morning, students. So, matter is classified into three groups: solid, liquid, and gas. And the characteristics of solid, liquid, and gas are based on the characteristics of matter. Particles of matter are always in continuous motion. There is a space in between the particles of matter, and particles of matter attracts each other. These three characters will decide the constitution of matter, whether it is solid, liquid, or gas. Good morning. शिव शंकर, कबीर सिंह, अमित कुमार, संगवर राज, गुड मॉर्निंग. शिव शंकर, गुड मॉर्निंग. गुड मॉर्निंग. दिस इज आवर फर्स्ट लाइव क्लास. विल ट्राई टू मीट अगेन एंड अगेन. एंड आई होप यू ऑल आर स्टेइंग एट होम एंड गोइंग थ्रू योर स्टडी. सो स्टूडेंट्स, in this lesson, what are the important topics that should be revised? The important topics are the states of matter, their characteristics of solid, characteristics of liquid. The characteristics are based on the, say, matters have least diffusion. Matter does not diffuse. Solid does not diffuse. Student, solid substance does not diffuse easily. In some rare cases, we find solid can also diffuse. Why it is so? It is because the particles of solids are held tightly together. There is a minimum interparticle space in between the particles and maximum interparticle force of attraction. And this is because the particles of solid cannot move all around or cannot leave one another so easily, and they do not diffuse with each other. Students, question related solid comes a sponge. However compressed is called a solid. A student, a sponge can be compressed when force is applied on it. It is called solid. It is because there are millions of holes in a sponge that traps air. When we compress it, the air in the holes escapes and the size of the sponge reduces. But when the force is removed, the sponge again regains its original shape. And this is why a sponge is said a solid. One more question related to solid is sugar, salt, however, acquires the shape of container in which it kept. Yet sugar and salt are said to be solid. A student, each crystal of salt or sugar does not change its shape. The crystal of sugar or salt are so small that large number of such crystals arranged according to the shape of the container, but the shape of each crystal remains unchanged. And this is why we say that sugar or salt are solid. However it changes, it acquires the shape of the container in which it is kept. Students, solid are least compressible, solid do not diffuse, the density, boiling point,
and melting point of solids are high, you may have learned that density, boiling point and melting point are high. The students,
particles of solid are held together with highest inter-particle force of attraction. So, energy required to overcome this force of this intermolecular force of attraction is more. And this is why more energy is required to given to the solid materials to change its state. And therefore, the melting point, the boiling point of solids are highest. And so about liquid. Liquid are also called fluid. Fluid means gases or liquid. Both are called fluid. Fluid means tendency to flow. Which can flow is called liquid fluid. So liquid can flow. Gases can flow and both are called fluid. Students, liquid possesses fluidity. Why liquid possesses fluidity? It is because the interparticle force of attraction of liquid is less than that of solid. And interparticle space is more than that of solid. So, the particles of liquid does not held together so tightly that can they retain their original shape, and hence a little change in the state, little change in the energy, the particles of liquid leave the other particles and flows, and so the liquid shows fluidity. Diffusion. Liquid have more diffusion than solids. For example, some liquid like when we dissolve alcohol in water, the diffusion each other. Diffusion means what? We have described it. The property of intermixing naturally. When two substances intermixes each other naturally, this is called diffusion. Water and alcohol intermixes each other, and so the diffusion rate of liquid is more than that of solids. Lalan Kumar is asking, why matter is not made up of big particles? Students, this is natural characteristics of matter. Naturally, this universe is made up of tiny particles, and matter is a part of the universe. So, this is the natural character of a solid. Thank you. Any problem you can ask? Yes, this is natural phenomena. Particles of matter attract each other because this is a natural phenomena. Law of gravitation also states that each and every particle of the universe attracts each other because particles have mass and existence, they attract each other. And the matter is also a part of the universe, and so the particles of matter attract each other. Hello. So the more convenient thing is to understand the three states of matter: solid, liquid and gas. And we should learn the comparison between the different properties of solid, liquid and gas, which will make us more intelligible to understand the states of matter. Dhan Kumar is asking, why are three states of matter? Students, there are three states of matter, and this depends upon the intermolecular force of attraction in between the particles. If the particles are bind together tightly, they will retain their shape, and if the particles are bind together loosely, they cannot retain their state. The energy, we have all previously said that the particles are always in continuous motion. Every particle has energy, and due to that energy, the particles are in continuous motion. The particles of solid are packed so tightly that they cannot move freely. They can only vibrate along the mean position. So the particles of solid cannot separate from each other. But the particles of liquid and gas have less interparticle force of attraction. They are free to leave from each other. Their kinetic energy is more than that of the solids. And so on the basis of this concept, there are three states of matter: the solid states, the particles in kinetic energy of solid states is the maximum. Liquid state, the kinetic energy of particles of liquid are less than solid, and the kinetic energy of the particles of gases are more than liquid and solids. Why there is a space between particles of matter? The first thing is, this is natural characteristics of constitution of matter. There is a space between particles. If the particles has more intermolecular force of attraction, they are attracted to each other. And if they have less force of attraction, they are not attracted to each other with such a greater force of attraction. So this depends upon the intermolecular force of attraction in between the particle. And if the force is less, there will be a space. And if the force is more, there will be less a space in between the particles of matter. A space is a characteristic feature of matter. and this depends upon the energy level of the particles of a matter. Yes, constitution of matter, that is how matter is, how the particles of matter are arranged and which type of particles are arranged in a particular way. So the constitution means the arrangement of the particles present in the in a particular matter, and which types of particle and the nature of arrangement, this is called constitution of matter. Which how they are arranged. Suppose a particle, a crystal of salt, sodium chloride, arranged in the form of lattice, and so different crystals are of different shape because due to the arrangement of the particles and nature of the particle present in matter, this is this forms constitution of matter. Yes, particles of matter are continuously moving because this is the nature of the universe. Each and every particles, however small or bigger, however large or small, all the particles of this universe are moving. The matter that we see around our ourselves are also a part of the universe, and the particles are also the part of the matter. So the particles remains in continuous motion. However, the nature of motion may be different. Particles of solid are vibrating along the mean position, but the particles of liquid and gases can move freely. Lattice means a specific constitution of particles. That is, you can say jal, a jal in the form of lattice. That is, in Hindi, you can say jal. Particles of matter contains energy, and the level of energy depends upon the nature of their motion inside the particle. The particles will only vibrate along the mean position, and if the energy level is the most, it may move freely in all the directions. Matter particles are tightly attract each other. Oh, matter particles are tightly attract each other because matter are of three types, solid, liquid and gas, and only the particles of solid are attracted tightly to each other. It is because the inter-particle force of attraction of solids are more. Yes. Particles of solids are moving, vibrating only, but particles of gases can move randomly in all directions. Matter is not made up of big particles. Students, initially we have discussed that matter is particulate in nature because they are made up of tiny particles. They are made up of small particles. substitution of matter begins with the macro levels at atom, the smallest particle of all the matter, and this is the constitution of nature, that particles are that matter is particulate in nature and they are in a small size. It also depends upon the constitution of matter. Suppose a matter is made up of sodium chloride. So here sodium chloride is a solid, and the constitution is sodium chloride is different than the constitution. If other matter is a gold, the particles of gold, each particles of gold is in the form of atom, but each particle of sodium chloride is in the form of molecule. So they differ in their shapes and size. Liquid particles can also move freely or no? Yes, the particles of liquid have less energy, less kinetic energy than gases, but more kinetic energy than liquid. So particles of liquid cannot move freely, but if a little amount of change in energy, if there is change in energy, the particles of liquid can also move freely. You can see in case of evaporation that when the liquid water is kept in a cup or anywhere, but particles of water escapes from the cup, that evaporates due to a little change in the energy level. So if the energy of liquid is changed, a little change in energy level, it can move freely, but if the energy of liquid remains the same, it does not move freely. Yes, chair is made up of small particles. We see the chair. Chair is made of materials. Material is obtained from matter. And matter is, suppose chair is made of plastic. So plastic that we have learned, plastic is a polymer, and polymer means a small unit, large number of small units combined together, joined into in to form a big molecule, that is polymer. So the constitution begins with the smallest particles. So chair is made up of small particles. Chair is made of polymers. Suppose chair is made of wood, and this is a cell. Wood is a good cellulose constitute goods, and cellulose is the polymer of glucose. So and glucose is the smallest unit of cellulose. So chair is a made up of a small particle. If they only made up of wood, if chair is made up of wood, no matter. Wood is composed of different chemical substances. So cellulose is the most important one. And for example, cellulose is a polymer of glucose, and glucose is the smaller unit of the wood. And so wood is, chair is also made up of a small part. Thank you, Rim Jim. Good morning, Sonali.
Good
Shiv Shankar Prasad ji, now you are in class 9th D. Yes, diffusion is very fast into other gases, isn't true. Diffusion, it is because the constituent, the particles of different gases are constituted in different way. Suppose sulfur dioxide is made of sulfur and oxygen, but hydrogen is only made of hydrogen atoms. Sulfur dioxide is made of sulfur and oxygen atoms. So a little difference in their density and their rate of diffusion may be. So I think diffusion in to the other gases may be fast. What is kinetic theory of matter? Yes, this is kinetic theory, means theory of movement. So theory of movement, in our real life, each and every particle is in motion, and this is true for all the living and non-living matters, that they have millions of particles which constitute the matter, and all these particles are in continuous motion. So applicable in our real life story. Yes, plasma, the fourth state of matter. Super excited ions. Super excited ions and electrons. Super excited and super energy composition of ions and electrons constitute the fourth state of matter. When electricity is passed through a gaseous medium in some certain condition, the particles of the electrons of the gaseous particles are removed, and these electrons are super excited and energetic, which mixes with the remaining part of the nucleus, which is also called kernel. And this composition of super excited and energetic electrons and the ions constitute a fourth state of the characteristics of plasma. Then characteristics of plasma is to shine. Plasma, when the formation of plasma gives out brightness, a shiny appearance. Bose Einstein condensate, when gases it forms a another state of matter. This is called Bose-Einstein condensate. The super excited ions, which is very active, and ions are very active. They are ready to bind with other particles, are said to be super excited. How evaporation causes cooling? Evaporation causes cooling because the required energy to change the state of matter is taken from its surrounding surface. And so, when the energy, the particles at the surface of liquid, or you can say water, takes energy from its surrounding, from the remaining particles of water, to overcome the interparticular force of attraction and to escape from the surface. It needs energy, and this energy is taken from the surface and the surroundings, leaving the remaining particles less energetic, which causes cooling effect. So at any surface, when evaporation takes place, energy required for evaporation is taken from the surface, which leaves the particle of surface less energetic, and hence it causes cooling effect. Effect of change of pressure in various states. Students, in solid states, there is invisible effect of change of pressure, because solid are generally mostly rigid. Particles of liquids are not rigid, so when pressure is applied on the particle of the liquid, its volume reduces to little extent. But when pressure is applied on the gaseous particle, its volume reduces to greater extent. That means the particles of gas are most compressible. Characteristics of particles. Particles are made of matter. Matters are made up of tiny particles. That is, matter is particulate in nature. The particles of matter is in continuous motion. And thirdly, there is interparticle space in between the particles of matter. What are the factors that affect evaporation? Students, there are four main factors that affect evaporation. The first one is temperature. Increasing the temperature, the rate of evaporation increases. Humidity. The rate of evaporation decreases when humidity of atmosphere increases. Wind speed. The rate of evaporation increases with the increase in the wind speed. And surface area contact. Surface, if the surface of contact is more, the rate of evaporation will be more. Rate of evaporation, surface area, temperature, humidity, wind speed, why steam at 373 Kelvin causes serious burn in boiling water. Yes, students, steam at 370 degree Kelvin causes severe burn than boiling water. However, the temperature of boiling water is the same. The steam contains more energy equivalent to latent heat of evaporation, 22.6 joule per kilogram, and steam when comes in contact of our skin, it releases energy equivalent to latent heat of more energy equivalent to latent heat of evaporation, and this is because it causes the property of camphor which makes it sublime. Property of camphor which makes it sublime. The particles of camphor are volatile. They directly changes into solid either interparticle force of attraction. CO2 is dry ice because when carbon dioxide is cooled at minus 78 degrees Celsius under high pressure, it changes into solid state, and this solid state having such a low temperature causes cooling effect, but it does not contain water, so it does not wet a body, a surface where it is kept, and due to this fact it is called dry ice. What is ice is effective cooling than water? Students, ice is more effective in cooling than water. However, the temperature of ice and water is the same, but ice contains less energy equivalent to latent heat of fusion, that is 3.35 joule per kilogram, and so when ice come in contact, it takes energy from the surface to be converted into water, and when a surface loses energy, it feels cool, and so ice is more effective in cooling than water. How rate of evaporation increase increasing the wind speed? Yes. if you squeeze a wet cloth and keep it under the moving fan, you can experience that it dries up very fast. Water droplets are seen on the surface of the glass containing ice cold water because due to ice inside the glass, the area around the glass loses its temperature, and due to loss of temperature around the glass containing ice, the water vapor present in atmosphere get condensed and which is seen on the surface of the water containing ice. Differences between kinetic energy. Energy due to motion is called kinetic energy, and energy contained in a body above the due to rest above the surface of the earth. Desert cooler better on a hot dry day. Desert cooler cools better on a hot day. The humidity of the atmosphere decreases a lot, and the desert cooler, which supplies air containing water droplets, water droplets increases the humidity of atmosphere with less cooling effect. So thank you, students. This is my first day, and I will try my best to see you again live with same topic or another topic, and I will inform you. Stay at home, keep learning. Our examination is going to be held from 25th of May of this month. So go through your book and ask questions on my WhatsApp number. You can ask directly. I will try my best to solve your problem. Thank you.